हेलो फ्रेंड्स, यू आर वाचिंग आईएससी मैथमेटिक्स एंड टुडे वी विल स्टडी चैप्टर नंबर 13 सेक्शन एंड मिड पॉइंट फॉर्मूले आईसीएससी क्लास 10 मैथमेटिक्स। बिफोर वी मूव फर्दर प्लीज डोंट फॉरगेट टू सब्सक्राइब एंड लाइक माय चैनल आईएससी मैथमेटिक्स। ओके, नाउ लेट अस सी व्हाट इज देयर इन चैप्टर नंबर 13 सेक्शन एंड मिड पॉइंट फॉर्मूले। Okay, in the previous class, class 9, we have studied the distance formula. Yes or no? Let us have a quick revision. What is that formula? We know that if suppose you have two points A having coordinates x1 and y1 and B having coordinates x2 and y2, then the distance between two points A and B is given by the formula square root of x2 minus x1 the whole square plus square root of y2 minus y1 the whole square. This is the distance formula, distance between two points A and B, okay, having coordinates x1, y1 and x2, y2. Similarly, distance of any point P whose coordinates are x, y from the origin or 0, 0. So distance OP is given by the formula square root of x square plus y square. This is the distance between two points whose coordinates are given and distance of a point from the origin O. Okay, square root of x square plus y square. So these two formulas we have studied in class 9. Now class 10 we will see the section formula and the midpoint formula. So first we will study the section formula. Section formula. Okay, what is this section formula? Let us see the theorem. If A x1, y1 and B x2, y2 are two points, then coordinates of a point, say we have point P which divides the join of A and B in some ratio m is to n, then the coordinates of point P which divides line segment AB in the ratio m is to n are given by x is equal to mx2 plus nx1 upon m plus n and y is equal to my2 plus ny1 upon m plus n. So this is the theorem which we are going to prove. For two points A and B given coordinates x1, y1 of A and x2, y2 of B, and we have a point P, okay, which divides the join of points A and B in the ratio m is to n. So coordinate of that point P are given by x, okay, this is the x coordinate of point P, x is equal to mx2 plus nx1 upon m plus n, and this is the y coordinate of point P, my2 plus ny1 upon m plus n. Clear? So this fact we will prove. Now, so I will remove this statement. Now let us draw a diagram in order to understand the section formula. Okay, suppose we have, okay, x and y coordinate axis, O is the origin. Line segment AB is taken such that the coordinates of A y1 and x2 y2. Okay, further P is a point on AB such that its coordinates are x, comma y. Okay, and the ratio in which point P divides AB is given m is to n. Clear? Okay, now we will draw three perpendiculars from A, P and B respectively. AM is a perpendicular from point A on x-axis. Similarly, BN is a perpendicular from point B on x-axis. We will draw one more perpendicular from point P on y-axis, MN. Okay, say here it is Q. Clear? Okay, again we will draw like this the two triangles. Okay, two more perpendiculars we are going to draw. AC and PD are the two perpendiculars drawn respectively from A on PQ and from P on BN. Clear? Okay. Now we know that A has the coordinates x1, y1, and therefore distance OM is given by x1. Okay. Similarly, distance OQ. Now PQ. Okay. If you find, if you want to find the distance OQ, you will see the x coordinate of point P, because PQ is perpendicular from point P. So distance OQ will be x coordinate of point P, that is x. And finally, in order to find distance ON, we will see the x coordinate of point P, that is x. Clear? Once again, OM, x coordinate of point A, x1. Similarly, OQ, x coordinate of point P, x. And ON, x coordinate of point B, that is x2. Now, if you want to calculate MQ, okay, here we will write down OM is equal to x1, OQ is equal to x, and ON is equal to x2. Okay, so MQ, we will calculate MQ is equal to OQ minus OM is equal to X minus X1. Similarly, we will calculate ON. ON is equal to, okay, let us calculate QN. We will require QN. QN is equals to ON minus OQ. Okay, will be given by x2 minus x. Clear? Now let us consider now perpendicular distances. Now distance AM will be given by the y coordinate of point A, which is y1. Okay, now since AMQC is a rectangle, and therefore AM and CQ will be equal, and therefore CQ will also be y1. Clear? Again, let me write down this here. Okay, if you want to find the perpendicular distance PQ, you have to see the y coordinate of point P, which is y. Clear? Okay, now, okay, distance PQ is y and distance CQ is y1. So PC will be obtained by subtracting y1 from y. So PC will be obtained by subtracting CQ from PQ. So PC is equal to PQ minus CQ, we will write down. Let us write down these facts over here. Here distance AM is y1. Okay, distance PQ, first we will write down all the perpendicular distances. PQ will be y, and similarly distance BN, y coordinate of B, that is y2. Clear? Okay, now in order to calculate, okay, AM and CQ are equal. y1 m is equal to cq is equal to y1 and pq is equal to dn, both are equal to y and this is y2. Now let us calculate distance PC. So PC will be given by PQ minus CQ is equal to y minus y1 and BD will be given by BN minus DN which is equal to y2 minus y. Clear? So we got the two lengths PC and BD. Okay, now triangle ACP and PDB will be similar triangles. Okay, now triangle ACP is similar to triangle PDB by AA axiom. Okay, by angle axiom we will consider that the two triangles are said to be similar. This axioms, similarity axioms we have studied in the previous class, class 9. So you must be remembering this. Okay, so if the two corresponding angles are equal, which are two corresponding angles? One is this 90 degree and another one is this corresponding angles. Corresponding angles, clear? So by two pairs of corresponding angles are equal and therefore the two triangles are called similar triangles. Clear? Okay, so now ACP is similar to PDB and therefore their corresponding sides will be proportional. We know that if the two triangles are similar, then their corresponding sides are proportional and the corresponding angles are equal. Clear? So here their corresponding sides will be proportional. So we will write, since ACB is similar to PDB, we can write that AC upon PD is equal to CP upon DB is equal to AP upon PB. Yes or no? Let us look at the figure AC. AC upon PD. Yes or no? Now AC and MQ will be equal. Clear? MQ will be equal to AC because opposite sides of rectangle. Similarly, PD will be equal to QM. Clear? Because opposite sides of rectangle. So we will get AC upon PD and then CP upon DB. CP, what is CP? CP is PC, Y minus Y1. Okay, so what we do, we compare first and third ratio first and then second and third we will take one by one. So let us write down over here. Therefore, AC upon PD is equal to AP upon PB and CP upon DB is equal to AP upon PD. Now we will substitute the values. AC, what is AC? AC is x minus x1, so x minus x1 upon PD is x2 minus x is equal to m by n, AP to PB. Okay, it is AP upon PB, not PD. PD. Clear? So m upon n and similarly CP. Okay, PC is y minus y1 upon DB is y2 minus y is equals to m by n. Clear? DB or PD is y2 minus y. Now we will simplify both this equation and make x the subject. Is it clear? I hope you have understood all the steps so far. If you have understood the diagram well, then you will understand this theorem. Okay, let's again let us have a quick look. Okay, line segment AP is given A as the coordinates x1, y1 and B as the coordinates x2, y2. P is a point with coordinates x and y. P divides line segment AB in the ratio m is to n, that is AP is to PB is given m is to n. We have drawn AM perpendicular to x axis, PQ from point P and PN from point B, okay, respectively perpendicular to x axis. Then we have calculated the length OM, okay, x1, OQ, x and ON, x2. Then we calculated MQ and QN. So MQ will be obtained by OQ minus OM, so x minus x1. Okay, similarly QN will be given by ON minus OQ, so x2 minus x. Clear? So these distances we have calculated. Then opposite sides are equal, therefore MQ and AC, MQ and AC will be equal. Similarly QN and PD will be equal, so we have mentioned over here. Now perpendicular distances, AM is Y1, PQ is Y and BN is Y2. Then CQ is PQ minus PC, PC is equal to PQ minus CQ, so Y minus Y1 we got PC. And BD is equal to BN minus DN, Y2 minus Y is equal to BD. Then ACB and PDB, two similar triangles we have taken. Okay, now in similar triangles we know that the corresponding sides are proportional. Clear? So corresponding sides are proportional and therefore we wrote AC upon BD is equal to CP upon DB is equal to AB upon PB. Clear? And then we equated first and third, second and third, and then we have put the values. Now we will simplify both these equations and make respectively X and Y the subjects. Okay, so here let us simplify n into x minus n into x1 is equals to mx2 minus mx. Therefore, we will transpose this term involving m, mx plus nx, and term involving n we will transpose on the other side, mx2 plus nx1. Take x the common, so m plus n into x is equal to mx2 plus nx1, and therefore x is equal to mx2 plus nx1 upon m plus n. So we got the x coordinates of point P. Clear? Similarly, we will take this second equation and simplify. Let us number the two equations 1 and 2. This is from 1 and from 2. Ny minus ny1 is equals to my2 minus my. Therefore, my plus ny is equal to my2 plus ny1. Take y the common, so m plus n into y is equal to my2 plus ny1, and finally y is equal to my2 plus ny1 upon m plus n. So we got the y coordinate of point P. Okay, so this is what we had to prove. X is equal to mx2 plus nx1 upon n plus n, and y is equal to my2 plus ny1 upon n plus n. Now we will treat this as a formula. Okay, this is called a section formula, finding the coordinates of x and y. Whenever you are given the coordinates of the endpoints of a line segment and the ratio in which a point lying on the given line segment divides. Clear? So remember, the values of x and y coordinate, because this only on the basis of this section formula only whole chapter x whole exercise will be solved. Clear? Now you have understood that if P divides line segment AB in the ratio m is to n, in that case the x coordinate is given by mx2 plus nx1 upon m plus n, and y coordinate is given by my2 plus ny1 upon m plus n. What happens if the point P is the midpoint of AB? We know that if the point P is midpoint of AB, let us number this equation 3 and 4. Then the ratio, if P is the midpoint of AB, then the ratio AP is to PB, that is M is to N, becomes 1 is to 1. Okay, let us mention over here. Now I will remove this little bit. Okay, so if P is the midpoint of AB, then the ratio M is to N is equal to 1 is to 1. Now let us put the values of M and N in the formula we have derived. For M and N both, 1 and 1 we will put over here, and therefore x is equal to 1x2 plus 1x1 upon 1 plus 1, that is equal to x2 plus x1 upon 2, and y is equal to 1y2 plus 1 into y1 upon 1 plus 1, which is equal to y2 plus y1 upon 2. Okay. In short, if P is the midpoint of AB, then the coordinates become x1 plus x2 by 2 and y1 plus y2 by 2. So this is called the midpoint formula. Clear? So I hope you have understood this section formula theorem very well. But the important thing is to remember the formula only. Clear? Okay, now we will summarize this. We will write down the formula, you will note down. Okay, number one, section formula will be given by mx2 or x is equals to mx2 plus nx1 upon n plus n, y is equal to my2 plus ny1 upon n plus n, and number 2, midpoint formula, x is equal to x1 plus x2 by 2 and y is equal to y1 plus y2 by. Clear? So we will remember these two formulas, and now on the basis of this we will try to find out the coordinates of the centroid of a triangle. Coordinates of centroid of a triangle. Okay, for this let us take one triangle. Say ABC is a triangle. Okay, and G represents the centroid of the triangle. Let us recall what is centroid. A centroid is a point of intersection of three medians of a triangle. So if AD, BE and CF are respectively the three medians of drawn from vertices AB and C, then their point of intersection will be denoted by G, which is called the center. Clear? And we remember the fact that the center divides the medians in the ratio 2:1. So this ratio AG:GD will always be 2:1. Okay. Let AD be the median of triangle ABC and G be its centroid. Okay, now A have the, let us consider the coordinates of A to be x1, y1, x2, y2, to be the coordinates of B, and x3, y3 to be the coordinates of C, and coordinates of G will be given by x, y. Okay, now we know that D, since AD is the median to BC, then D is the midpoint of BC. This one here, D is the midpoint of BC, and in this lecture only we have seen the formula to calculate the coordinates of median of a line segment if the endpoints coordinates of the endpoints are given. So D is the midpoint of BC, and we have coordinates of B and C. So according to formula, x1 plus x2 by 2 and y1 plus y2 by 2. So here x2 plus x3 by 2 and y2 plus y3 by 2 will be the coordinates of D. Yes or no? Therefore, coordinates of D will be given by x2 plus x3 by 2, comma y2 plus y3 by 2. These are the coordinates of D. Clear? Now, G is the point which divides the join of A and D in the ratio 2:1. Now we can use the section formula to find the coordinates of G. So, here value of n:n:2:1, and therefore coordinates of G will be given by mx2. Say coordinates of A to be x1, y1, and coordinates of D to be x2, y2. Then this value is x2 and this value is y2. And if you put in the section formula, okay, let me write down the formula first. mx2 plus nx1 upon m plus n, comma my2 plus ny1 upon n plus n. Clear? What is x2? x2 is x2 plus x3 by 2. So let us put the value. So m into x2 plus x3 by 2 plus nx1 upon m plus n, and this is x, and y is equal to m into y2 plus y3 by 2 plus ny1 upon m plus n. Okay, so if you simplify this expression, you will get okay, let us further simplify. Okay, now value of m:n is given to be 2 and 1. So let me write down here for m2 and for n1, so that we can directly simplify. Okay, here 2 plus 1 will be 3. Here also I will mention 2 plus 1 will be 3. Clear? Because we don't have steps, so we are not going to show all the, we don't have space, and therefore we will not write all the steps. Okay, now if you simplify this expression, so this 2 will get cancelled, so numerator will be x1 plus x2 plus x3 by 3, and similarly here also 2 will get cancelled, so y will be equal to y1 plus y2 plus y3 by 3, and therefore we will get x is equal to x1 plus x2 plus x3 upon 3, and y is equal to y1 plus y2 plus y3 upon 3. So these are the coordinates of the centroid G of a triangle. So remember, if the three vertices, coordinates of the three vertices of a triangle are given, then you can use this formula to calculate the coordinates of the centroid. The formula is x coordinate is given by x1 plus x2 plus x3 by 3, and y coordinate is given by y1 plus y2 plus y3 by 3. Clear? So we have seen section formula as well as midpoint formula and how to find the coordinates of the centroid when the three vertices of a triangle are given. Now let us start the exercise. Now we will start exercise 13. There is only one exercise in this chapter. Okay, let us begin with question number 1. Okay, you are given the coordinates of endpoints of line segment AB. Coordinates of A and B are given. -2, -7, and 6, 1. Ratio m is to n is given to be 5:3. We have to find the coordinates of P. Okay, we will calculate the coordinates of P. We have to find out. Obviously, here x1, y1. x2, y2 and m is 2 and all the values are given. We can directly use the formula. Okay, we have a section formula. We have x is equals to mx2 plus nx1 upon m plus n, and y is equals to my2 plus ny1 upon n plus n. Simply put the values, all the values are already given. M is 5 into this is x1 y1 and this is x2 y2, so mx2, that is 6, plus n is 3 into x1 is -2 upon 5 plus 3, and y is equal to 5 into y2, y2 is 1, plus n is 3 into y1 is -7 upon 5 plus 3, and therefore -6. So 30 - 6 / 8, comma 5 1 = 5, here ±7 3 = 21. So 5 - 21 / 8, y is equal to, therefore x is equal to 24 / 8, and y is equal to -16 / 8. Therefore x is equal to 3 and y is equal to minus answer. Let us solve the next question. Okay, question number one. It was the first part, now we have the second part. Coordinates of point A are given to be 4, minus 3 and coordinates of B are given to be 4, 2. Okay, point P is given such that ratio AP is to AB is 2:5. Find the coordinates of point P. Now let us try to understand this with the help of diagram. It was the ratio given is AP is to AB. AP is to full line segment AB. AP is 2 parts. Okay, and AB is 5 parts. So PB we can calculate 5 minus 2, 3. Clear? So this is important. Okay, here AP is 2 and AB is 5 and therefore PB is equals to AB minus AP 5 minus 2 and therefore PB is equals to 3. Since we have to find the coordinates of point P, we require the ratio AB is to PB. So you cannot directly use the ratio AB is to AB, remember. Okay, we want AB is to PB. So PB is 3 and now AP is 2, PB is 2, 3. Now you have got the value of M and N. So we can use the section formula. Okay, now draw coordinates of point P will be given by the formula MX2 plus NX1 upon N plus N, comma M by 2 plus N by 1 upon M plus N. Let us put the values. This is X1, Y1 and this is X2, Y2. M is 2 and N is 3. Okay, substituting the values in the formula, 2 into 4 plus 3 into 4 upon 2 plus 3 and y is equals to 2 into 2 plus 3 into minus 3 upon 2 plus 3. Therefore x is equals to 4 to the 8, 4 3 is the 12 upon 2 plus 3, 5 and y is equals to 4 minus 9 upon 5. Okay, now further simplifying, x is equals to 20 by 5 and y is equal to minus 5 by 5. Therefore, x is equals to 4 and y is equal to minus 1. And therefore, coordinates of point P are 4, minus. Just go through the question solution fast. So here the important task is this: finding the ratio AP is to PB. Okay, once you got the ratio, then use the formula, put the values, you will get the answer. So second part of question number 2 we have completed. Now question number 2 we will solve. I hope you have understood this. Thank you. generally coordinates of A are denoted by x1, y1 and coordinates of B are denoted by x2, y2 and coordinates of P are given by x, y. So here x1, y1 and x, y are given. X2 and y2 are unknown. Ratio m is to n is also given. No problem. We will put the formula, put the values to get the answer. Okay, now coordinates of point P are given by the formula x is equals to mx2 plus nx1 upon m plus n and y is equals to my2 plus ny1 upon m plus n. Remember that this is x1, y1, this is x2, y2 and this is xy. M is 2 and n is 3. Clear? Now we will put the values. X is 1. Therefore 1 is equals to m is 2 into x2 is x plus 3 into x1 is 3 upon 2 plus 3 and y is equals to again m is 2 into y2 is y plus 3 into y1 is minus 6 upon 2 plus 3. Okay, here value of y is given, coordinates of P minus 2. Clear? Now we will simplify. Therefore 1 is equals to 2x plus 9 upon 5 and minus 2 is equals to 2y minus 60 is 18 upon 5. Is it clear? Now further simplify to find the values of x and y. So 5 under 5 is equal to 2x plus 9 and 5 into minus 2 minus 10 is equal to 2y minus 18. Therefore 2x is equal to 5 minus 9 and 2y is equal to 18 minus 10. Therefore x is equal to minus 4 by 2 and y is equal to 8 by 2. And therefore x is equal to minus 2 and y is equal to 4. And therefore coordinates of point B are minus 2, 4. Go through the solution once again. Okay, so here we have to find the coordinates of x2 and y2. Coordinates of point P were given, m and n, x and x1, y1 were given. We have used the formula once again and we have put the values. Here important thing is to identify the values, which values are given. Okay. Substituting the values properly in the formula is very important. Sometimes students are getting mistaken. Okay, they are confused whether which value is to be put x1, y1 and x2, y2 and where to put x and y. So remember always that in the formula, x and y are the values of the point which divides the given line segment in a certain ratio, in a given ratio. Clear? Okay, so here point P divides AB in the ratio 2 is to 3, therefore values coordinates of P will be x and y, while the endpoints of the line segment will be respectively x1, y1 and x2, y2. Now again, you must not have any confusion in taking x1, y1, x2, y2. It is not compulsory that you take the points of coordinates of A to B x1, y1. You can take this coordinates to be x2, y2 and coordinates of B to be x1, y1. Here you can interchange x1, y1 and x2, y2 values. Okay. But this value you cannot interchange with any one of A or B. P cannot be interchanged. Clear? So remember these few things. Okay. Otherwise this chapter is very easy. Now let us solve the next question. Question number 2 we have solved. Now we will solve question number 3. 3. Keep studying. for any doubts, you can ask anytime. Okay, please call me anytime after 2 o'clock.